Hello! In this video, I'm going to show you how to use JSP for including other files. So the common use case for including files is including standard headers and footers. So say, for example, you're building a website and you want to have the same header and footer information displayed on every page. So you can simply create the header and footer in separate files and include them in your JSP files. Alright, so when you include a file, you can include either HTML files or JSP files. It's totally up to you. So at the top here, I do a JSP include and page equals my-header.html. A similar thing here at the bottom, I can do a JSP include page equals my-footer.jsp. And that's it. Very simple, very straightforward. Alright, so let's go ahead and try this out. So let's move into Eclipse. What I'd like to do is to continue to use that existing project, JSP Demo. And let's move down to the Web Content folder. And what I want to do first is create those files I'm going to include. So first I'm going to create the header file. So I'll say new file. And I'll give the file name of myheader.html. So that's the header that we're going to include. And when you're happy with the file name here, click Finish. So for the header, I simply want to give the name JSP Tutorial. So I'm going to set up H1 and I'll make the alignment for it to be center. And then inside the tag here, I'll just say JSP Tutorial. So this will be included on all pages for, you know, my given website that I'm just making up right now. So I'll go ahead and save this file. So this is our header file that we have set up right now. Now let's move over and let's create our footer. So again, on web content, I'll do a right click. I'll say new file. And I'll call it myfooter.jsp. So in the footer, we actually want to add some JSP coding. So once we're happy with the file name, go ahead and click finish. So for here, for the footer, for every page, I want to give the time the page was last modified, or just, we're just going to kind of make this up actually. So here I'll just say last modified. Or last updated, and then I'll just drop in the actual date timestamp. So that way all of our pages look fresh every time a user will visit our website. Now I'll just hit the save button. Okay, great. So now at this point we have our header complete and we also have our footer complete. So now we can go ahead and create our main page that's actually going to include these files. So I'll move over to the web content folder. I'll do a right click. I'll say new file. And I'll call this homepage.jsp. And once we're happy with the name here, we'll click finish. So on this homepage, what we're going to do is we're actually going to include information from the headers and the footers, and also we'll put some of our regular content here. So I'll do the standard work here for our HTML and our body. And now what I want to do is import or include the header. So I'll say JSP include, I give page equals myheader.html. And now I can enter some regular content that I'll have on my homepage. Here I'm just going to put in some filler stuff, just some blah, 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 just to, you know, placeholders here. And then I'll copy this line X number of times just to kind of fill it up a little bit. So that's our content. Let's go ahead and include our footer. So I'll say JSP include page equals myfooter.jsp because our footer is a JSP file. And again, it can go either way, HTML or JSP, depending on how you want to build out your pages. And that's it. So I can go ahead and save this file. And then I can go ahead and run it. All right. So I can move over to this file, homepage.jsp. I can do a right click. And then I can say run as, and then run on server. Okay, great. This looks really good. So up top, we have our header file that we included, JSP tutorial. Then we have all of our body, our blah, blah, blah stuff. And then we have the actual footer. And then notice how the footer is a JSP, and it included the current timestamp when this page was accessed. So our site will always look fresh as far as our fresh content, which is a good thing, right? So good job. In this video, I showed you how to build JSP pages by including other files.